Though ice fishing is definitely not advised on a lot of lakes for obvious reasons this weekend, starting today, the DNR is implementing some big changes to its record fish program, and it could open the door to a whole lot of new state records in the year to come.
There aren't many Minnesota fish.
White sucker.
Chad Hootmacher.
Dogfish.
Isn't familiar with.
There's largemouth bass.
Last summer, Boyd Hooper's Land of 10,000 Stories gave us all a glimpse at Chad's record-keeping prowess across the Land of 10,000 Lakes.
Shovel no sturgeon.
As he supports his son Caden's pursuit of catching all 63 Minnesota species counted.
Channel catfish.
By the DNR.
He's got 9 left and he'll have caught every one with a recognized record.
Make that 10. As of today.
Yellow bass is one that has really caught on popularity in certain parts of the state.
Yes, yellow bass is added as the 64th species eligible for a new certified weight record. But that is hardly the DNR's biggest change. 11 of the state's most popular fish species are also being reopened for certified weight records, placing the long-standing and uncertified records into their own category.
Some of those records have been publicly questioned for a long time, and we want to be able to still recognize those records, but open those records up for new submissions using certified scales.
Mandy Erickson says the DNR is also taking new submissions for catch and release records, which rely on witnesses and photo evidence, expanding eligibility to 18 new species to maintain healthy fisheries.
This catch and release program expansion recognizes both those anglers' desire to sometimes not harvest a fish and the regulations.
I think it's a great, great thing for fishing. If you keep taking your biggest and strongest fish out of the gene pool, you know, by having to kill them to take them in to try to get them certified, eventually it's going to start affecting the quality of that fish species.
Quillback.
Chad says nearly all of the display fish of Caden's catches are painted models, except for this real short-nosed gar.
Plaque from the Minnesota DNR.
His one certified record.
Yes, sir.
Though if it happened today, it would have been a different decision.
Definitely, we would have rather have let that fish go after getting the measurements and stuff on it.
And speaking of those measurements, catch and release applications still require plenty of documentation.
You want to make sure that you take as many photos of that fish as you can, so there is no question what that fish is and how long that fish actually is.
And if you're wondering about it opening the floodgates to digital fish stories.
There are some really impressive Photoshop and AI apps out there, but when people submit record applications, DNR staff is going to really take a close look at those photos. We'll be able to tell some of those things, but a lot of it is just going to be on anglers realizing that this program is supposed to be fun. It's supposed to encourage the sport.
Hopefully there's enough people out there that have enough, you know, morals where you're not going to take somebody's state record. I mean, otherwise, what does it mean? You know, you always know that, you know, you cheated on it or whatever.
How many people do you have in your photo verification department right now? Because I'm guessing that is going to be a big job.
It will be a huge job. All of the applications that will be submitted will come to me, and I'll have a team of 4 or 5 coworkers that will help take a look at these photos and applications and make sure that things are verified.
Have you put in for a pay increase yet?
No, we'll see how this year goes. But you know what? This is a really fun part of the job. You know, it never seems to be a ton of work talking to anglers about their catches, looking at photos of big fish. It's part of the job that is really enjoyable.
I bet it is. Anglers seeking one of those new certified or catch and release records will get detailed information along with their 2024 licenses. Of course, it's also online, and we have links along with this story on care11.com. And again, it does take effect today, but the opener for walleye, several other popular species, of course, isn't until May 11th.